Mousy Brown!
Oh, yeah!
Oh, I can be up on these boxes.
Oh, me too! This is the one where he goes up and down the candlestick.
Candlestick's ready!
Ready! Mousy Brown's ready!
Ready!
Then here we go! Was in town, so he curled himself into a ball and rolled himself right down.
Oh,
let's do it again. Let's do it again.
Yes, and this time we can be up and you can be down.
All right.
Have you got your candlestick ready?
Ready. Ooh.
Here we go then.
Yeah.
Up the tall white candlestick, climb little Mousy Brown. Right down.
One more time.
All right, one more time for Doodles.
Yes!
Yes.
Up the tall white candlestick, climb little Mousy Brown. Right to the top, but he couldn't get down. So he called to his grandma, grandma, grandma. But grandma was in town, so he curled himself into a ball.
I'm sure I left it here somewhere. Oh, yes, it's here.
Oh, what have you found, Fizz?
A mouse.
Oh.
It's like Mousy Brown, and I want to put it in my scrapbook so I don't forget it.
Wowee, Fizz has got a cat book.
Found it.
Fizz, is that your cat book?
Yes, Jake.
Oh, why do you want to put your mouse into a book of caps?
No, Jake, it's a scrapbook. A book of scraps.
Oh, well, I leave scraps of food on my plate sometimes, but my mum tells me to eat them. I don't put them in the book. It'd go soggy.
Oh, Jakey, not scraps of food. Scraps just means things that I've collected that I liked, like pictures or things I've made.
Oh.
Look, I'll show you.
Okay.
Now then, this is my scrapbook, and in it I've got things that remind me of something I did that was fun.
Oh, look! Oh, there's a photograph of when we played streams. Oh, that was fun. I remember that.
Yes. You see, Jake, the picture makes you think of when we played streams. That's how a scrapbook works, actually.
Oh, go on, then. Oh, open it. Right, then. Oh, look. Oh, it's a tree on the lollipop stick. Oh, does that mean you like tree-flavoured lollipops?
No, Jake.
What?
Remember, once we made some signs, and this sign means park.
Oh, yeah. Oh, there were signs all over the place.
No.
Tweenie's crossing.
Ice creams.
Yum.
Park.
Yeah.
Yes, all those signs told us what was where.
Yeah. Even the toilet.
Now then.
Right. Oh, that's a funny sign. Hey, it looks like my grand's doilies. Oh, that's it. It means beware doilies. Or perhaps it's a hat and it means hats at work.
No, Jake. It's a snowflake.
Huh. Well, why hasn't it melted?
Because it's a paper snowflake that I made the day we met Jack Frost.
Oh, yeah. He flew around and made everything cold and covered things in ice.
So cold.
Oh, me too. Look, I've got icicles hanging from my nose.
Ah, I like remembering what we've done years and years and years ago.
Oh, Jake, we didn't do these things years and years ago.
Well, when then?
Well, just a few weeks ago, that's all.
Oh, longer ago than yesterday.
Yes.
Ah, but not as long ago as dinosaurs.
No.
No, because Max told me they lived in prehistorical times.
Prehistorical? That was a really, really long time ago. But we did all these things during the last few weeks and months.
Oh, I know that. Yesterday was only one sleep ago, but last week was a few sleeps ago.
That's it, Jake. Now, I wonder what comes next.
Oh, I see. Oh, fees! Flutterby wings!
Oh, yes. I painted these the day after Doodles got stuck up in the tree. And I imagined if I was a butterfly, I could fly up to get him.
Oh, yeah. And I thought about being in a balloon.
Look at my beautiful wings!
Could fly like a butterfly, fluttering up and down. Fly like me, I'm a butterfly, fluttering up and down.
Up, down, up, down.
High up to the sky like a butterfly, then down to the ground.
Doodles, hold on to me, I'll fly you down.
I can't reach. You're too fluttery.
Oh, wow! Chucks away!
Woo! I wish I could fly in an aeroplane, flying up and down. Fly like me in my aeroplane, flying up and down.
I can't. You're flying too fast.
Oh.
Oh, well, never mind.
Whoa. Oh, yeah. Oh, look down there. Let's go. I wish I could fly in my big balloon, flying up and down. Fly like me in my big balloon, flying up and down.
Up, down, up, down.
High up to the sky, I wish I could fly, and then down to the ground. Oh, come on, Doodles, climb into my basket, and then we can float gently to the ground.
Ooh, sounds good to me.
I just need to get a bit nearer.
Oh, no. The balloon's going to hit the tree!
My balloon popped!
Oh, yes! And I remember that we did get Doodles down in the end!
Oh, yeah! Max went and got him down by climbing up a bladder!
Oh, ladder, Jakey! Ladder!
Oh,
oh, look!
Oh, well, that's just an old leaf. What's next?
It's not just any old leaf, actually, Jake. It's a brown leaf. Remember when I thought all the trees were dying because their leaves were falling off?
Whirling, twirling, sailing, curling, spinning down and round and round. I'd like to be a leaf. Shadows underneath a lovely golden leaf in autumn. Round and round and round and round, round
floating, falling, spinning down and round and round. Oh, I'd like to be a leaf, yeah, in autumn. Yeah.
How I'd like to be a leaf, casting shadows underneath, a lovely golden leaf in autumn.
Oh, I'm a leaf, an autumn leaf falling to the ground.
Whoa, twirling, twirling, twirling. Oh, that's great. What's next? What's next?
Yes, right. Just get the page.
Oh, look. It's Milo with the great big red chicken pox. I had chicken pox, but I didn't turn into a chicken.
Oh, no, Jake. It's not a chicken pox. No, it's a nose. Oh. A big red clown's nose. Just like the ones that we wore when Milo was a clown.
Oh, yeah.
I'm late, it was so good of you to wait. Now watch me juggle all these balls around. Never mind, I've got another. Spinning plates will be no bother. Oh, steady. No, it wouldn't be a circus if it wasn't for the clowns. Hey! Amazing when the circus band is playing. Put me in my sports car, it will take over the way. Amazing tricks for cheering and hooray. No, it wouldn't be a circus if it wasn't for the clowns. No, it wouldn't be a circus if it wasn't for the clowns. It wouldn't be a circus if it wasn't for the clowns.
Like a spoon with a hole in.
It's a bubble blower. Remember, Bella showed us how to blow bubbles.
Oh, yeah. I'd like to be a bubble and float and float and float. Be a bubble. Let the weather do its worst. I'd like to be a bubble and float and float and float. Be a bubble and float. As light as air, being blown anywhere. We've done lots of different things, haven't we?
Yes.
Hey, I'm going to start my own scrapbook so I can remember everything we do.
I can help you if you like, Jake.
Oh, thanks, Fizz. Fizz, if you wanted to remember today, would you have to put a scrapbook in your scrapbook?
Oh, Jake.
Here he comes with a giggle and a hop, running so fast that he just can't stop. Hello, Spot.
Hello, Spot.
Spot, hello.
Hello, Spot.
Happy little puppy, always on the go. Hello, Spot. Wait for me. I want to come along and see the things you see.
Spot and Sam were walking in the park.
Listen, Dad, said Spot. What's that noise?
It sounds like a band playing, said Sam.
Oh,
let's go and see.
Spot's friends had come to see the bear too.
Spot!
Hello, said Spot.
Is this right?
That's my mum playing the tuba, said Helen.
Oh, this is splendid. She's very good, said Spot.
Thank you, said the conductor. That's all for today.
I know. Why don't we make our own band? Said Spot. We could go to my house. Great! Let's go, said Steve. See you later, Mum.
Spot and his friends ran upstairs to see what instruments they could find.
I'm sure there are some in here, said Spot. Look, here's a drum.
Oh! Hooray, said Tom. Can I play that?
You'll need these, said Steve. Ah! That's now good!
What about this? Said Spot.
A trumpet! Great!
What shall I play? Asked Helen.
Ah! I know! Wait there! Said Spot.
Excuse me, Mum, said Spot. Are you going to do some cooking, Spot? Asked Sally.
No, Mum, said Spot. We need these for our band.
Oh, here you are, Helen.
Oh, thank you, Spot.
Oh!
Going to play, Spot? Asked Helen.
I can be the conductor, said Spot.
Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4.
Listen to the music of my band. Listen to the music of my band. Can you hear the drum go boom?
Boom!
Can you hear the drum go boom? Listen to the music of my band. Listen to the music of my band. Can you hear the cymbal clang? Can you hear the cymbal clang? Can you hear the trumpet too? Can you hear the trumpet too? Listen to the music of my band. Listen to the music of my band. Listen to the music of my band. Listen to the music and see what you can hear.
Wonderful, said Sally.
What a great band,
said Sam.
You can have your lids back now, Mum.
Thank you, Spot, said Sally.
Now I can join your band.
Goodbye, Spot. Time to go. Such a happy little puppy. We always love you so.
Woof, woof.
Postman Pat, Postman Pat, Postman Pat, and his black and white cat. Early in the morning, just as day is dawning, he picks up all the post bags in his van. Postman Pat, Postman Pat, Postman Pat, and his black and white cat. All the birds are singing, and the day is just beginning. Pat feels he's a really happy man. Everybody knows his bright red van. All his friends will smile as he waves to greet them. Maybe you can never be sure, there'll be knock, ring, letters through your door. Postman Pat, Postman Pat, Postman Pat and his black and white cat. All the birds are singing and the day is just beginning. Pat feels he's a really happy man. Pat feels he's a really happy man. Pat feels he's a really happy man.
It was a lovely summer morning in Greendale. Pat had finished delivering the village letters. Morning, all!
Morning, Pat!
Hello, Pat. Just the weather to make the garden grow.
What a day. Well, seems to be growing in here. I've never seen so many flowers. Mrs. Goggins?
Morning, Pat.
Mind your back. Hello, Sam. More flowers. There'll soon be no room for letters. I'll just put them here for the time being.
Thanks, Sam.
I hope I've not brought too many.
Oh, Sam, we'll need a lot more if we're going to win the competition.
No problem. There's plenty more. What's this competition you're on about?
Oh, Pat, you must have heard about it.
The best village competition, of course.
So we'll have to do our best. I'm going to cover this old post office with flowers.
I wondered what was going on. I never saw Greendale look so bright. I thought it was the nice weather. I suppose there'll be some judges coming to pick the winner.
Yes, Pat, but nobody knows when they're coming. It'll be a surprise, like. Just to keep us on our toes. Bye for now.
Bye.
Cheerio.
Well, I'd better get on with the post. Flowers or no flowers.
Oh, Pat, when you call at Greendale Farm with that parcel, will you collect something for me? Mrs. Pottage promised me some tubs to put the flowers in outside the shop.
I'll remember. Don't worry. No trouble. With all this sprucing up going on, I'll not be able to forget. Bye.
Bye, Pat.
Whoops. Oi, look out. Hello, Ted. What are you doing up there?
Hello, Pat. Just giving the wall a spot of fresh paint. For this here competition. It's grand stuff, this new paint. You can put it anywhere.
Yes, I've noticed. Even the letterbox has come out in spots.
Aye, it flies about a bit. It'll come off with a bit of a rub.
I don't know about best village competition. I reckon they should call it the busiest village competition. Oh, my van. It's caught the measles.
Eh, dear. No, I don't know how that's happened. It does look a bit sickly. You'd best take it to see a doctor.
It's your blooming paint. You meant to paint the post office, not everything for miles around.
It needs a drop of water to get it off. Drop in at my place and I'll give it a good hosing down. See you later, Pat.
Bye.
We'd better get a move on, then. Look at your nose, Jess. You'd better watch out. Ted'll be giving you a hose down if he sees that. It was time for a quick wash. Pat went to Greendale Farm first to get the tubs.
Oh, Pat, hello.
Hello there.
And to give Mrs. Pottage her parcel.
Thank you, Pat. The tubs are just over there by the barn, Pat. But keep a watch out for any strange plants you might see.
There were some very odd blooms in the tubs. Goodness me! A greater flowering Katie and a giggling Tom tree. What will Mrs. Pottage grow next?
Hello, Pat. We're talking plants as well.
And we can help you put our tubs in your van.
This one first. Well, it looks like it. I'd better take it to see Dr. Glenn. He's good at curing spotty vans.
Goodbye.
Bye for now.
Goodbye.
Pat was on his way. He stopped at Ted Glenn's. Looks as though Ted's ready for me.
Hey, old Pat.
Hello, Ted.
Hey, I thought you'd forgotten, Pat. I'll have to be quick. I've got to get down to Pencaster Station tomorrow to catch a train for Scotland.
Where are you off to, Ted?
It's young Caroline's wedding. Can't miss that. There's all sorts to do before I go. And I can't leave Mrs. Goggins with that hole in her roof. Anyway, I've got Peter Fogg lined up to give me a lift to the station on his motorbike. It'll be a day or two before I get back. And I don't want to leave the lorry down at the station. It might disappear. So I'll leave it in the village. When I finish Mrs. Goggins' roof. Then you'll be able to keep an eye on it for me.
Good idea, Ted. Have a good time at the wedding, and thanks for cleaning the van.
Ta-da, Pat!
Cheerio! The next day, the village was covered in flowers. There were tubs and flower pots in every street. Window boxes and baskets overflowing with plants. Flowers everywhere. Any time now, the judges would arrive to choose the best village. The next day, the phone rang in Pat's house.
Hello? Yes? Oh. Are you sure? I mean, it is Ted's. Oh, you'd know it anywhere. Oh, what's it doing there? Just sitting there looking ugly. Oh, goodness. All that work making the village beautiful. I'll tell Pat. I'm sure he'll think of something. Yes. Yes, right now. I'll tell him to hurry. Goodbye.
And here is John.
What's up?
Ted's left his lorry right by the village green. The judges for the competition are due any minute. It'll be the first thing they see. And all the flowers and work. It'll all go to waste.
We'll ask him to move it. I expect he's gone to mend Mrs. Goggins' roof.
No, he's not at Mrs. Goggins' and nobody can find him. His workshop's locked and empty.
Oh, now I remember. He's gone to Scotland, to Caroline's wedding. I meant to tell you, he'll be gone for a few days. I'd better go and see what I can do.
Good luck, Pat. Bye.
Bye.
There the lorry was, just as Sarah had said, with Peter Fogg and Mr. Pringle scratching their heads. They had tried to move the lorry, but the thing would not budge an inch. Oh, what a pity! Right by the village green, The judges simply cannot miss it.
What's all this? What's going on?
Peter Fogg and Mr. Pringle explained to PC Selby about the lorry and the judges.
Parking is allowed here. Quite legal. Can't do anything to move it. Where's Pat? He might think of something.
Pat had met Major Forbes at the post office, and he was telling him what had happened.
Tell you what, sort of thing we did in my army days. We'd cover it up. Hide it. Camouflage. That's the word. Right. Let's start. By the left. Quick. March.
Alf came with his tractor and trailer to give a hand. And Peter Fogg loaded it with more flowers.
Right you are, Alf.
Pots and shrubs.
Off you go.
They all helped. Miss Hubbard was there. Dorothy Thompson found some big sheets of green cloth with pretend grass. Then the shrubs arrived.
Well done, everybody. Keep it up.
First the sides of the lorry were let down, then they covered it with the imitation grass, put the shrubs on, together with some flower pots, and with a bit of fencing in front, it looked like a garden. The phones were ringing again, all over Greendale.
Hello? What? We have? Miss Hubbard, we've won.
Won? Did you say we've won? The best village competition?
Lord bless us. What wonderful news.
Well, twins, our tubs must have helped. We've won after all.
Hooray! Yippee! I knew we could do it.
Well, isn't that just marvellous news, Pat? That'll put Garner Bridge on the front page of the Pencaster Gazette.
I hear that the judges like, best of all, the special hillock covered with lovely flowers. Now, I never knew we had any such hillock in the village.
Well, it won't be there for long, so you'd better get a good look at it. Yes, the judges couldn't believe their eyes. They came back twice to have another look.
A day to remember. It certainly was.
Has anybody seen my lorry? I left it in the village before I went to Scotland and, well, I don't seem able to find it now.
There's a mystery for you, PC Selby. Ted's lost his lorry. Nobody seems to have found a lorry. All I've heard is about flowers. Bushes and flowers, lots of them.
Will somebody tell me what the joke is?
Turned a lorry into a bunch of flowers. They what?
Postman Pat, Postman Pat, Postman Pat and his black and white cat.
Around. He's rolling.
smellers get around. Whee!
Goldfish. Got any, trees, Zoe?
Sounds like a rip-snorting idea to me.
What's that, Pappy?
Going fishing on my boat. What you say?
But your boat's in the backyard, Pappy.
Course. How else you gonna go yard fishing?
Yard fishing, yard fishing. So it gets big fish.
Oh, you betcha. I'll get it all ready.
What kind of fish we gonna catch in the grass?
Fix us up a lunch, Ole.
Okie dokie, Pappy. Make sure Spot doesn't get into the sandwiches, though. Because you know how nuts and bolts Spot is about peanut butter.
Hey, ready for some fishing, kids? Oh, I mean, mateys?
You bet, Pappy. I mean, aye aye, Captain. Now we catch big fish.
Good day for yard fishing.
What kind of fish we gonna catch in grass, Pappy?
Yard fish, Ole.
Big fish! Zoe catch big fish!
Oh, we don't catch yard fish with hooks, Zoe. Yard fish, you need special bait. Like the sticky tape hula popper. The fetch and catch magnetron. And the good old gum grabber.
What's this, Pappy?
Oh, that one's the best of all. The three-fingered finagler. Wow! good for catching yard fish. Let's try her out.
I got one, Pappy! What kind is it, Pappy? What kind of yard fish is it?
Well, now, I'd say you caught yourself, a chunky tuna tin, Ole.
Wow, hear that, so? I caught a chunky tuna tin. Yard fishing sure is fun, Pappy. Pappy, I got another one.
Jumping gyroscopes, Ole. This could be a big one.
You think?
Well, now, I'd say that was a rainbow trout.
Some catch, huh, fella? Spot? Nothing that Spot likes better than peanut butter sandwiches. Right, Zoe?
Zoe, no catch big fish.
It's okay, Zoe. Just takes a little practice. Don't give up. You can do it. Come on, I'll help you.
Only help fish?
You bet, and you can use my lucky fishing rod with Pappy's three-finger finagler.
Okie dokie, Ole. So we catch big fish.
like it's time for the Smiler.
What's the Smiler, Pappy?
Your teeth?
I bet your bolts. No way my teeth are gonna let a lunch get away from them. Eyes ain't what they used to be. It's up to you, Zoe.
Your church sure like peanut butter.
All together. Easy does it now. Nice and slow. Well, looks like we saved the lunch.
You bet.
And Zoe has been.
Darn tootin'. And I'd say that's a ring-eyed dogfish. Yep. Biggest I've ever seen. Yep. Looks like these two have the right idea. I think it's time we set sail for home.
Aye, aye, Captain. Land ho!
You're a sailor after my own heart, Odin.
That was fun, Pappy.
Darn tootin'.
Maybe we can go yard fishing again, Pappy.
Anytime, Ollie. Anytime at all.
Like they're waiting for someone important. It's the big town superstar.
We'll be right back. jewels.
Stop them!
Day. The weather's just perfect.
Perfect for relaxing and doing nothing.
No, I meant it's the perfect weather for spring cleaning.
What's spring cleaning?
Well, when the springtime arrives, we do lots of tidying and washing and sweeping and dusting. Oh, I love spring cleaning. It's my favourite job on the whole farm.
Cleaning's not my favourite job.
Ah, what is your favourite job then, Quack Quack?
Looking after my brothers and sisters, of course.
You can spring clean them, dear. Oh, it's going to be such fun. Woof woof, Oink and Oinky can tidy up the farmyard.
Yes, Moo Moo.
And Nene and Baba, you can sweep and dust the big barn.
Yes, Moo Moo.
And I shall do the washing.
I suppose I should start with cleaning your little cart. The only trouble is, where am I going to put you while I'm cleaning it? Ah, I'm sure Woof Woof won't mind if we borrow his basket for a short while. What is this dirty old thing? Oh! Now then, Tilly Dilly Milly Willy Billy and, Jilly, I'm sure it will be very comfy, even if it does smell a bit like a puppy.
Ooh, we'll soon have this farmyard looking as neat as a newly mown field.
Oh, let's do the cleaning.
You duster here, you duster there, here, there, here, there, then take
Do a lot of dusting and your arm will ache. That's when you take a break.
Oh, let's do the cleaning. Oh, let's do the cleaning. Oh, let's do the cleaning. We'll make the farm look great, great, great.
We'll find washing here, washing there. Here, there, you find it everywhere. You scrub and rub and dub it, then you hang it out. That's what it's all about.
Oh, let's do the cleaning. Oh, let's do the cleaning. Oh, let's do the cleaning. We'll make the farm look great, great, great.
You do the sweeping here, the sweeping there.
As fast.
Oh, let's do the cleaning. Oh, let's do the cleaning. Oh, let's do the cleaning. We'll make the farm look great, great, great.
Oh, oh, that singing about the spring cleaning has worn me out. I'll just have a little dog nap. Stop! Oh, oh, you'll squash Tilly Milly Dilly Billy Jilly and Willy. What are Tilly Milly Dilly your brothers and sisters doing in my basket?
Taking their nap, of course. I had to borrow your basket because I was spring cleaning their car.
Oh, that's all right. I'll just take my blanket and sit somewhere else.
Oh.
Where's my blanket? My favourite blanket. Oh, what have you done with it?
I haven't done anything with your blanket.
But it was in here. It's brown and soft and scrunchy. And I've had it ever since I was born.
All I saw was a dirty old bit of cloth, and I threw that out. I couldn't have my little one sleeping on that.
You threw it out?
Oh, I'm sorry, Woof Woof. I didn't realise. Oh, anyway, it must still be round here somewhere.
I'll sniff it out.
Oh, that shouldn't be too difficult.
I must find my favourite blanket. Oh, I can't sleep without it.
Oh, dear.
Baba, I've nearly finished.
Clean, fresh washing. It's one of my favourite smells.
Mumu, I've made you a present.
For me? Oh, how kind. Thank you. What is it?
It's a washing hanger-upper. You hang your washing on it. And when the wind blows, the washing hanger-upper will spin and dry your washing really quickly. Like this. Oh, oh, it just needs a few minor adjustments.
Oh, not here. Not there. Oh, what am I going to do?
Oh, what's the matter, Woof Woof, dear?
Oh, I've lost my favourite blanket.
Ah, maybe Moo Moo washed it.
Oh, yes. I've washed everything today. Let me see. What does your favourite blanket look like?
Well, it's brown with green bits on, and it's got a picture of a dog in the corner.
Brown with green bits. I've got pink hats and purple hats, a red apron and a blue tablecloth, but nothing brown with green bits, dear. Sorry.
Oh, what am I going to do? It's time for our afternoon nap, and I won't be able to sleep without my favourite blanket.
Oh, don't worry, Woof Woof. We'll find a way to help you sleep. Oh, now then, everyone. We're going to play a little game to help Woof Woof fall asleep.
Oh, goody! What do we have to do?
We're going to count sheep. I've heard Mr. and Mrs. MacDonald say that counting sheep helps them sleep.
That's not going to take very long. We've only got one sheep to count.
I know. Baba can move around up and down here and there. She can pretend to be a whole flock of sheep. And everybody else, including Woof Woof, has got to count her.
No. I'll give it a go.
One. Two.
Over here.
Three.
Blanket.
Why don't we try counting pigs? It sounds a little unusual, but I suppose it's worth a try.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
Can't we just look for my blanket instead? It's brown with green grass stains and a picture of a dog in the corner.
Oh dear. Maybe a song will help you sleep.
How?
Well, when I was a little calf, Nene used to sing to me to help me sleep. So come along, everyone. Moo with me.
Our poor little wolf, what are we going to do? Without his favourite blanket, there's nothing he can do. He reckons that without it, he'll never get to sleep.
It doesn't seem to help him, counting pigs and sheep.
Where's it gone? Where's it gone? Where's it gone? Where's it gone? He's been searching all day long. Woof-woof's blanket gone.
It's very soft and comfy, but wearing rather thin. I like to wrap it round me, tucked up to my chin. I must admit it's full of holes and showing the odd stain. I won't be very happy till I see it once again.
Where's it gone? Where's it gone? Where's it gone? Where's it gone? He's been searching all day long. Where has Woof Woof's blanket gone?
Perhaps you'd like a new one in yellow or in red.
Something thick and woolly to put upon your bed.
We could make it purple.
Or would you like it blue?
How do you make a blanket?
I haven't got a clue.
I just want my own blanket.
Where's it gone? Where's it gone? Where's it gone? Where's it gone? He's been searching all day long. Where has Woof Woof's blanket gone? Where's it gone? Where's it gone? Where's it gone? Where's it gone? He's been searching all day long. Where has Woof Woof's blanket gone? Where has Woof Woof's blanket gone?
I wish I knew.
Oh! Has the song made you feel sleepy, dear?
No.
I'm going to look for my blanket.
You know, Sheepdog Shep from Shropshire doesn't have a favourite blanket.
Doesn't he?
No. He doesn't even have a favourite basket. Sheepdog Shep can sleep anywhere.
Really?
Mm.
Oh.
I know what might send Woof Woof to sleep. Why don't you read him a Sheepdog Shep story, Oinky?
That would be great.
Are you coming, Oinky? I mean, Oink.
Meh! Do you think Woof Woof would like a pink blanket with green stripes? Or a green blanket with pink stripes? Or a blue with orange spots? Or orange with blue spots? Then there's always red with yellow triangles, or purple with white zigzags. Or we could just use every colour in my wool basket. What do you think?
I think it's a very kind idea, Baba. But what Woof Woof really wants is his tatty old blanket back. And it's all my fault.
There, there.
Sheepdog Shep from Shropshire had a great time staying with his old Uncle Lucky. During the day, they rounded up the sheep and put them in their pens. And when it was bedtime, Shep snuggled up in Uncle Lucky's spare basket. You see, Woof Woof, Shep didn't need his favourite blanket to... Woof Woof? Woof Woof? He's fallen asleep! I did it! I did it! Yeah! Oink! Oink! Guess what?
I'm coming, Uncle Lucky. Sheepdog Shep to the rescue.
Oh, I'm so sorry, Woof Woof. I didn't mean to wake you up.
Did you say you woke me up?
Yes, I didn't mean to. Only I...
If you woke me up, that means I must have been asleep.
Oh, you were. And you didn't need your favourite blanket.
No, I didn't. From now on, I'm going to be fine. As long as I have my favourite story, that is.
Oh.
Oh! I feel so terrible about it, Moo Moo. I should never have thrown Woof Woof's blanket out of his basket.
A brown blanket with green marks on it and a picture of a dog. I just don't understand what's happened to it. It's a complete mystery.
Guess what, everybody? I can sleep without my favourite blanket.
All I did was read Woof Woof his favourite story and he went straight off.
Oh, well done, Oinky darling.
Oh, that's great news. Hooray!
Of course, I would still like to find my favourite blanket.
Aha! Did you say your blanket had a picture of a dog on it?
That's right, Oinky.
Then that must be your blanket!
But my blanket is brown, with green grass stains on it.
I know what's happened. I've washed it, and it's come out all clean and white as new.
Oh, I'd forgotten my blanket was meant to be white.
I'm so happy for you, Woof Woof.
It looks a bit odd, that colour.
Moo!
That looks better.
Oh no, Woof Woof. Your blanket is all dirty.
You'll have to give it to us to wash again.
I'll do it, Nene, if you show me how. I want to make sure it doesn't go missing again.
Oh, you are a funny little puppy. Come along, then.
I may not need my favourite blanket anymore, but it's great to have it back.
My friend Angel Mouse and I heard a sort of tapping, rapping, knocking sound.
What's that noise?
It's coming from outside.
Where?
There.
Huh. It's only a bird.
Hey, I'm a bird.
Then you should look after her.
Looks like she prefers you. She's copying everything you do. Wait, there's a message. It's from You Know Who. It says, please find a good home for this little chick.
Do I have to?
Of course you do.
I won't if she keeps copying me.
You Know Who won't be pleased.
Oh, all right. I know just a place to take her. Look, I found something she can't do.
She's only a baby. You've got to help her.
Hello, Angel Mouse. What do you want?
This little chick needs a home. Can she live here?
Could she help in the shop?
Oh, yeah. All you got to do is show her what to do and she'll copy you.
I'm making up an order for Ellie, Mum. Let's see if she can help. One bag of flour.
Come on, chick. You do it too.
I'm sorry, Angel Mouse. She's far too messy to live here.
You're right. She'd be much happier in a messy home. Now let me think. Who's really messy? I know. Oswald's always messy. You can live with him. He even looks like a chicken.
I don't think this is a good idea, Angel Mouse. Nibblings! Nibblings!
You'll let this little chick live with you, won't you, Ozzy?
Can she escape? Can she escape?
No!
Look out, look out!
We need to find someone safer than Oswald.
He in the bush, she in the bush.
Let's try Spencer. Hello, Spencer. Can this little chick come and live with you?
No, she cleans cars.
Watch her. Let's go, chick. Come on, chick. Oh, no.
You know what, my boy? That chick's only a baby. I don't think she wants to live with an old bear like me.
You think she should be with someone younger?
Much younger.
Hello, Ellie, Mum. I've got a big favour to ask you. Can this little chick come and live with Baby Ellie?
Baby Ellie's too young. She can't even look after herself yet. But look.
See? They're friends already. And they can learn things together.
I'll think about it, but right now it's time for Baby Ellie's nap.
The This really would be a good home for the little chick.
Yes, and she'd be a little friend for baby Ellie.
Then everyone would be happy.
You're right. You're an angel, Angel Mouse.
And so the little chick found a good home, thanks to my friend, Angel Mouse.
Angel Mouse.
It was a beautiful autumn morning in the garden. The leaves on the trees had turned golden brown and had begun to fall.
Good morning, Boo.
Boo seemed to be very busy.
Morning, Weed. Lovely day. Still, can't stand here chatting all day. Nests to build, etc.
Wow. I wonder what he's up to.
Bill and Ben told Weed that they'd find out what Boo was up to.
Ooh.
And off they scampered after him. Bill and Ben wondered why Boo was filling a box.
Nearly made me jump out of me prickles, you did. What is it?
The flubbadubadox.
This? Well, I do it every year. I'm getting ready for me hibernation. Now, if you'll excuse me...
Flubber-lub-a-nation.
Bill and Ben didn't know what a hibernation was. They asked Boo how big a hibernation was.
Flubber-lub-a-dig.
And if it talked.
Flubber-dish-a-da-dog.
And did it bite.
Flubber-lub-a.
Well, I'm a bit too busy to explain, I'm afraid.
The flower pot men still didn't know what a hibernation was. But they didn't like the sound of it. They ran to tell Weed all about it.
It's a flubber-dubber-nation.
A flubber-dubber.
Oh, you are a couple of sillies. Some animals go to sleep for the winter. That's what hibernation is. It's to save energy when there isn't much food around. And that'll be why he's been eating so much. He's building up a store of fat to see him through the winter.
A flubber-dubber winter?
Yes. He'll sleep through the whole winter.
Flubber.
Bill and Ben thought that Boo might be grateful for a bit of help building his nest. So they went to the potting shed to see what they could find.
Oh, those two off again.
Bill found some green string.
Flop it up!
And Ben found an old duster.
Woo! Flop it up there.
Flop-a-dop-a-boo.
Well, it's very kind of you, but I've just about finished. And now, if you'll excuse me, I'm going to have a little nap. See you in 3 months or so.
Flop-a-dop-a-daddy.
And a flop-a-dop-a-dottle. Thank you. Thank you very much. Very, nice.
And so Boo settled down for a nice, long sleep.
Flubber-lubber-deep-bow.
Flubber-deem.
Flubber-lob.
Doisy bellies. Hey, keep the noise down. Some of us are trying to sleep.
The flowerpot men realised that they'd been making rather a lot of noise. They decided that if Boo was going to get any sleep, things would have to be a lot quieter around the garden.
Well, I don't know.
Oh, yes, I remember.
Yes. Well, I don't know. I mean, I would have thought that you'd have known all about that, really.
Flogger hobbit sleepy.
We magpies don't hibernate.
No, from the nation.
Oh, what a hard winter that was.
Yes.
I thought I'd eat the flobber-dobber-dobber-dob. Flob.
Why do they have to make such a noise keeping quiet?
Slubber-dubber-dub.
Slubber-dub.
Oh, yeah, yes. Oh, what is it? Oh, it's you two. What do you want? Shush. But I wasn't. I mean, but it's...
Flogger, logger, heep. Flubber Nation.
But I wasn't making any noise. Oh, now clear off the pair of you.
Flubber Nation.
Funny pair. What are you up to this time?
Flubber-boo-a-leap!
Well, he won't be for much longer. Not with the noise you've been making.
I say, I've just found a really interesting piece of gravel. It's,
The garden was now very quiet. In fact, it was too quiet. Bill and Ben were getting very fed up. Keeping quiet wasn't much fun at all.
Oh, yes. Lovely and quiet, isn't it?
Flubber-dubber.
Bill said that, yes, it was. But it was very boring keeping so quiet.
Well, if you've got nothing better to do, I suggest you go and hibernate like Boo. Give us all 3 months' peace.
Flubber-date. Flubber-date.
Bill and Ben thought that Slow Coach's suggestion was an excellent one, and they scampered off to build themselves a nest.
Flower pot men don't hibernate.
Flubber-lubbly.
Where'd he gone? Hooligans, it shouldn't be allowed. Flubber-dubber-dub.
Bill and Ben thought that perhaps they ought to build their hibernation nest together.
Oh, no. I wish I'd never suggested the stupid idea in the first place. Hear them? Oh, they're building a nesting box.
This hibernating's a good idea.
Flubber-dubber-dub.
Bill and Ben explained that they were only doing it because keeping quiet was so difficult. They couldn't play while Boo was asleep for fear of waking him.
You call that keeping quiet? I've heard quieter dynamite.
Well, it seems that he's slept through it so far. So there's no need for you to,
keep quiet any longer.
Flubbery!
We laughed as the flowerpot men celebrated. At last, they could play and make as much noise as they liked once again. Woo!
Dog like Kipper. That's Kipper the dog. Now that's a frog.
Sing, oh sweet.